I collect stuff. Some people call it junk. I like to call it memorabilia. Either way, it piles up high. And one day, I just had to get out of my apartment. Yeah, I picked up a stack of old newspapers. I figured I'd look through them down at the park. Yeah, the kids were having fun there playing with their boats, and the old guys were having fun playing bocce. At least I thought they were having fun. I plopped down on a park bench. The yellow college rag was peeking out of the pile, begging to be read. 34th Street, published by the Daily Pennsylvanian, February 12th, 1970. Interesting. I scanned the front page. Whoa, what's this? This is a Soul Comic magazine, an educational experiment. Welcome readers, you are just in time to watch the beginning of the end of the careers of four superheroes.
Imagine, if you will, that it is student night at Tilden's School Annex. Ready? Then turn the page.
Here it is, page 3. William Vitka, on finding Green Lantern in class. That's interesting. He starts off with a quote from John Dewey. Abandon the notion of subject matter as something fixed and ready-made in itself, outside the child's experience. See it as something fluent, embryonic, vital. Vitka was reporting on Byron Preiss, a freshman at the University of Pennsylvania and tutor at the Tilden School Annex, an elementary school in Philadelphia serving 5th and 6th grade at-risk students.
Let's see, the scaffold approach, the book distribution, reading aloud, enacting drama, reading it, supplemental vocabulary. Wow!
Whatever happened to this guy Byron Preiss and his comic book idea? I had to get back to the house and get on the internet. What's the first thing I found out? Bam! Byron C. Preiss, president of Byron Preiss Visual Publications and iBooks, died in a traffic accident on Saturday, July 9th, in East Hampton, New York, on his way to Temple. Preiss was 52 years old. I don't even know the guy, and already he's dead. Boy Wonder working with inner-city kids makes it to the big time like 4th of July fireworks at Coney. Youthful, energetic, and fun, but gone too soon. So what was Byron Preiss's story? It might not amount to a hill of beans, but a guy like that has got to have some lasting influence on society, doesn't he? Porsche. Too far. Got to back up a bit. P-R-E... Aha! I always knew he had a brother. Preiss. Great idea. Then boom, gone. I went back onto the internet to see what else I could find out about this guy. He started off with comic books, but then he worked his way into illustrated novels, and then eventually wound up working with the Bank Street School of Education. He published children's books as well, and books by Billy Crystal, Jane Goodall, Jay Leno, Leanne Rimes, Jerry Seinfeld. He embraced the new technology. CD-ROMs, e-books, audiobooks, and even won a Grammy in 1985. So I guess he really did leave a legacy. The article finished with another quote from Dewey. The child is the starting point, the center, and the end. His development, his growth, is the ideal. It is he and not the subject matter which determines the quality and the quantity of learning. I've done my job. Now it's up to you. You want to find out more about Byron Preiss? Check out some of the links that I provided for you.